politicians have cowered and leaders will rise. And I think that in this particular budget, we've seen at least, I think, a slow, standing up for, I think, deep issues in the affordability questions for people living in British Columbia. And I think that it's going to be one of the big questions is that certainly we've seen a lot in terms of housing affordability, but then one of the big challenges will be on the topic of transportation and economic development. They've really attempted to go after both supply and demand, and I think that that is certainly a strength of this particular budget. Going on to the issue of transparency, it's really touched upon the issue of assignment sales, really the pre-sales that have pretty much driven much of the residential real estate market, particularly the condominium market in metropolitan Vancouver, and in moving forward towards a much more progressive levels of taxation, that indeed the pursuit of looking at increased things like increased school taxes and transfer taxes for properties worth over $3 million. I think that only, and it's actually good news, that it pursues a property that those properties that are only about 5% of all residential properties in metropolitan Vancouver. And as such, it really, I think, presents itself as a much more progressive approach and a much more a modern approach to the nature of residential real estate in British Columbia. The first budget, I think it's a good start for a new government. I think that it is, I think, trying to take leadership on issues that really there wasn't much leadership over the last couple of years. And I think it's trying to, I think, deal with topics through which have been developing or really smoldering for a number of almost nearly a decade and a half, and that this is really a first step. And I think finally it's going to be, proof is in the pudding, that I think it's going to come out in the implementation, I think, as this budget rolls out in the coming months. But we shall see its successes.